everybody, it's me Denise, aka the Designing Woman, coming to you with a video. I know it's been a while, but I wanted to work on some things while I've been away. And as you can see, I've got a little bit of new equipment. I got me a ring light for Christmas, so that really was a motivating factor. Today I'm here with some new products as well as a wig review. So this video is gonna be a little bit different. It's not live, but I would appreciate for you guys to comment, and any questions you have, just leave your comment below and I will answer them. So we're gonna get into this look. I'm gonna start with my primer, which is Pore Professional by Benefit. I like this primer because I have some acne scars and some pretty large pores, and it just helps to me to minimize some of those things. All right, for my brows, I'm gonna be using Kat Von D's Super Brow, and it's a 24-hour brow pomade. I'm using it in the color Walnut. And to apply it, I'm gonna be using my Eco Tools Angle Brush. That's what it looks like. And remember, your eyebrows don't have to be perfect. I'm just filling mine in, but I will be going behind it with some concealer to kind of clean it up a little bit. And for the front, I'm just doing like a little upward stroke. Yeah, this is my first time actually purchasing this product. I've tried it a few times in Sephora. But this is a pretty new product for Kat Von D. But I am a Kat Von D fan as far as her eyeshadows, liner. She has my favorite liquid liner, which is the Tattoo. And it's called Tattoo, and it's in black. I know this look crazy right now, y'all. I know it do. But it's gonna look just fine in a second. So right now, this jump looks super crazy. Alright, so I'm going to take that same brush and I'm going to clean it up with the LA Girl Pro Conceal in the color Toffee. No, in the color Fawn. So I'm going to use this. And you can get this at your local beauty supply store. I'm here in Columbia, South Carolina. I got it from King's Beauty Supply on Broad River. But I'm about to just go in and clean this up. Some people get their eyebrows even by drawing a line across. Sometimes I do it, sometimes I don't. It just depends. But for the sake of this tutorial, I'll do it. Y'all, my eyebrows haven't been waxed in forever. And because I feel them in so much, it kind of makes me lazy with getting them waxed. Because I can conceal that. But sometimes it gets to a point where it's kind of hard to conceal. I'm going to take a blending brush and blend this part in. Be careful when you guys are doing this because you don't want to wipe away anything. So. Okay, I just went and did that real quick. I know y'all like, dang, her eyebrows super thick. I'm about to do something about that right now. Y'all ain't got to say nothing. Some people get caught up on making their eyebrows perfect. I personally, I like for them to be as perfect as possible, but my two eyebrows are completely different, and most people don't have perfect real eyebrows. And sometimes if you focus on having perfect eyebrows, they end up looking like bird wings. Like it's a bird getting ready for flight. One of my eyebrows is more curved, the other one has more of a sharp arch. So I tend to do these eyebrows the same way. Wipe away the first part. I don't have to do this, but I'll do it because I like to get more of a natural look. I really want to do a brow class, like an actual class. Because some people can watch videos, but they really need to see it in person. Or they need that one-on-one help. So, I can get that. You can get that if I have this class. And there's several different products you can use on your brows. You do not have to use what I use. Because some days I could use this Kat Von D stuff. Another day I might use a 99 cent pencil from the hair store. It just depends on my mood and how much time I have. So, do what you're comfortable with. If you're new to this, you may be more comfortable with a pencil. So I'm going to take that same concealer. Well, no, I'm not going to take that concealer right now. I'm just going to go and blend this in a little bit more. And I have a new palette that I'm going to be using tonight. And it is the Boss Mood Palette by Morphe. And I just got it last night from Ulta for like $24. Y'all, look at these colors. Look at that. Bam, I'm excited about this. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm just doing this video because it's been a while and I have a little bit of time. I've been off this week, so I decided that I'll do this. Let's see here. I'm gonna take a blending brush. This is a blending brush that came in my Ipsy bag, and y'all have to pardon the appearance, but this is the blending brush, and it's clean. I've cleaned it. It's just stained really bad from some of the shadows that I used, but I'm gonna go in with the transition color. Let me get the right name for you. So I'm gonna go in with Play It Cool, and that's this color right here. Play It Cool. So I'm gonna go in there with a transition color. And again, y'all, this is my first time using this palette. So we about to see what it's all about. And I just go back and forth like that in a sweeping motion. Just build it up a little bit. If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? Love me, won't you? So I think next I am going to go in with photo. I think I'm gonna do photo, which is right. Photo is this one right here. Yep. Y'all, again, I don't have an idea of where I'm going with this. I see certain colors that are sticking out to me, especially for this wig that I'm gonna be wearing. So yeah, just bear with me. Y'all see that? Y'all hear that throwback Danity Kane show stopping in the background, y'all? Me and my friend were riding back from Atlanta, right? And we were talking about how in high school, what songs were out, and music back then was a little bit more innocent than it is now, especially secular music. In particular is what I'm talking about, but I mean, people talked about stuff, but you really didn't know that they were talking about sex or whatever they were talking about. And so we went on a journey through music history, and Danity Kane was one of those groups that was popping back then when I was in high school. And I don't know if I'm going to do a cut crease or not. I kind of do and I kind of don't. I might do a semi cut crease. Okay, so let's see here. With my two ladies and cities. Bam. Oh, like a real showstopper. Okay, so now I'm about to go in with Power Slayer. It's like a purplish color, like right here. So I'm gonna go in with that. And it's a little bit dark. I'm just trying to deepen this crease so I can really get the look that I'm going for. And y'all notice I'm using the same brush. Y'all don't have to do that. I do it because it's just easier than grabbing all those brushes. And sometimes it helps with the blending a little bit better. To me it does anyway. I'm not saying that that's what you have to do. You just want to deepen it, deepen that crease. Yeah. Showstopper. All right. Hey. Product shizzle. This beat is hypnotic. This beat flows right through my chest. Hey, grab somebody. All right, now I'm gonna go in this corner purple, and the name of that is Transformer. So that's right here in the lower corner, and it's like a dark purple. Let me see you. I'm just gonna do it like right there. Boom. I'm just going back and forth in a sweeping motion. You don't want to, you want to do it lightly. It doesn't take a lot of pressure to do it. Blend that a little bit more. You can never blend too much. And this is my first time using this palette. I think I told y'all last night I had a gift card, y'all. And I don't know if it's just me, but I put a lot of thought in when somebody gives me a gift card versus cash, what I'm going to spend it on. Because it was so many things that I wanted to do. And I mean, it wasn't like a large amount on there. And we all know that makeup is expensive. Quality makeup is expensive anyways. So I wanted the new palette by Morphe, but when I got the Ulta, they told me that they didn't have any more and it was no longer, I guess it wasn't gonna restock because it would be re-released in January. And I was heartbroken. Those of you that follow makeup and are Morphe fans, y'all know which palette I'm talking about. So, all right, y'all see that? All right, so now what I'm about to do is go in and cut my crease. I thought about using shape tape to cut my crease because I got a lighter color in my Ipsy bag and it just was not working for me. So I said, I'll just use this to cut my creases from now on. But I think I'm gonna go in back with Fawn Again, LA Girl Pro Conceal. Boop, that's it right there. And I'm gonna cut my crease with it. And I think I'm gonna do a semi-cut. I don't know yet. I'm trying to do something that's not really gonna clash with what I'm doing with my hair. I have hooded eyes, so I tend to go above my crease line. Just because you don't want your cut crease to be lost and you want people to be able to see all the work that you put in. So if you go right into your crease with the concealer, like you see this eye right here, this eye appears that I have more lid space because I cut the crease above the line. When people see me do this, they always say, you have to have a really steady hand. No, y'all don't. I had a shake all the time. Well, not all the time, but y'all get me. I don't have the most stable hands out there, but if I can do this, you can do this. And you always want to, it makes it easier if you angle this right here, which is another reason why I do my eyes first before I do my foundation, because you don't want prints in your makeup. Is a little hard for me. I know a lot of people can't tell, but to me, I have two different eye shapes. My face is not symmetrical at all. I feel like I got one side of my face from my dad and one side from my mom. I'm still beautiful nonetheless, but it makes it a little bit more difficult when I'm doing my makeup. And I don't necessarily let this dry, because I want the eyeshadow to stick to it. And I use the concealer because it makes the eyeshadow pop a lot brighter. So I'm going back into this Morphe palette. Uh-oh. Y'all, I done dropped the doggone sheet to tell me what color's what. But I'm going back into this Morphe palette. And this color is called Confidence. I think I'm gonna use Confidence. Let me see. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do Confidence. And Confidence is this color right here. It's got like a glitter to it. If y'all can see it up close, I don't know if y'all can or not. But yeah, so I'm gonna go on in there. And the brush I'm using is an e.l.f. eyeshadow brush. These are $1. You can get them at the drugstore, Walmart, pretty much anywhere, honestly. And so what you want to do, I'm just gonna take the belly of the brush and pat on the inside of my eye. You don't want to do a sweeping motion because it's actually sweeping away what you've already done. So I'm just taking and pressing the belly of the brush on my eyelid. And again, this is the Morphe Boss Mood Palette, or known as the 35V, I think. Yeah. Y'all see that come? What y'all think? Like I said, y'all, I'm just freestyling. Kiki, do you love me? Cause I want you. Yeah, I love to dance. I do. And I love music. Music is like therapy for me. I love all kinds, except for heavy metal and like that weird stuff, that screaming music where they be screaming. That type of stuff, that demonic stuff. I call it demonic. I'm sorry, I don't want to listen to nobody screaming in no microphone. Can't understand what they say. But yes, I listen to all kinds of music. I really love gospel music, worship music, gospel rap. I love country music, y'all. Country music is fire, for real, for real. They write about some real stuff, and it don't be it don't be. It's not bad stuff. They write about some real life situations. And so right next to confidence is red carpet. So I'm gonna go in there with that color. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do red carpet because it's next to it. And again, I'm just gonna place it right now next to this color. And then what you want to do is you want to blend this on the inner job. So I'm gonna go back in the last color I used and I'm finna just do this because you don't want any really harsh lines. This is another Eco Tools brush that I'm using. And it's a blending brush. Well, it might not be a blending brush, but that's what I'm using it for tonight, y'all. People use certain brushes for certain things. And yes, some of them come and they tell you what they're for. But I believe that brushes don't have rules. All right, y'all see that. Brushes don't come with rules, and that's my philosophy. Because everybody can't have the same technique. I mean, you can, but if I can handle that brush better than a different brush, or if that's what I learned with, then hey. I remember when I only had like 3 or 4 brushes. And I could achieve a look like this. Now, of course, certain brushes make things easier. Y'all see how I place that? It's like a red. And like I said, that's the color red carpet. And it's right next to confidence. So, I'm liking this right here. I haven't done anything like this in a while. And I'm going in and I'm going to blend it. Blend it because you don't want no harsh lines. Yeah. Yep. Then I'm going to go back in to Transformer on this end right here. And I'm going to blend it. I think I'm done with my eyes. Some people do the like highlight thing up there. I don't think I'm about to do that. I ain't got time for all that. But what I am about to do is do my liner. And this is my favorite eyeliner, y'all. It is Tattoo Liner in the color Trooper, which is black from Kat Von D. Y'all, this stuff is the truth. You hear me? The truth. The truth, the gospel truth, okay? Let me get me some tape real quick. Put it on the corner of my eyes, y'all. This is a trick you can do sometime, which my eyes ain't even, so shoot, this might not even work for me. It does work, but sometimes it's still have a problem. So I'm struggling with this tape. Let me just get another piece. think that's even. I don't know. This is even as it's gonna get tonight. But anywho, so can you see that? And I do my liner a little bit thicker because one thing I learned from watching other artists is that when you put your lashes on, your eyeliner tends to disappear sometimes. I mean, you can see it, but you can't really see it. So I started doing mine a little bit bolder. Y'all, whatever works for you. Like, I have to do this crazy stuff like this. Oh, shoot. Uh-oh. I'll do that right there. Bam. Can't hardly see it. Y'all watching this video, but please believe in no way am I perfect. I'm still learning, you know. I do this professionally. I believe you never stop learning, or you shouldn't ever stop learning your craft. So sure, it's dark as I can get it. So, now my wings probably gonna look like two different things, but that's okay, cause I ain't going nowhere but to bed. Yep, I'm doing all of this before I go to bed. Yeah. So now it's time for foundation, and I am going to use probably a combination of foundation. What did I do with that 358? Oh, here you go. Right in front of me. Duh. Okay. So, one of the most common questions I get is, what's a good foundation? Y'all, there are tons of good foundations. My advice is that you find what works best for you. I like drugstore brands. I also like really expensive brands. But you have to figure out your budget, your what you're willing to spend. First of all, how good you are. Because there's... I'm not going to say there's no use in investing in a product when you're not good, but if you're learning, I would say start off with drugstore. Some people believe the opposite. Like, you could get MAC. A lot of times if you get premium products, which means they come from Sephora, Ulta, MAC, you use less product, but there's a difference between spending $49 on a foundation and $5 on a foundation, or $6 or $7 or $10. That's a big difference. So you have to figure out what you're willing to invest into makeup. Today I will be using 358 Maybelline Fit Me, and I might mix it with a little of the Superstay Full Coverage. And this Maybelline is supposed to last up to 24 hours. And this color is 356, Warm Coconut. So I'm just gonna put it, I put it on my hand. And I barely got any of this left, y'all. I be scraping just because sometimes I get lazy. I don't wanna go get no more makeup, I mean. Get my brush, and I'm gonna swirl it around. Y'all, my brushes, I just cleaned a few of them. Some of them I mess up, so I'm gonna be using the Wet n Wild brush, y'all. I don't know, it's a stippling foundation brush, but this set came from Walgreens. It was on sale for $15, and it came with like 10 brushes or something like that. But it's a pretty good set to be Wet n Wild. Y'all, I'm matching my chest. My neck is dark due to some health issues, but I match my chest. And sometimes I do bring my makeup all the way down. Y'all love this song. Tell me when you love a lie. Baby, tell me when you love a lie. Y'all, guess what I forgot to do? My under eyeliner. I sure did. And I ain't got no cotton down here to really do it with. Hope I got my perversion liner down, huh? All right, I didn't do any color correct, man. Sometimes I do, but tonight I ain't have time for all that. But what I am gonna do is fix this right here. I can see that where it was. And then what I'm gonna do is go in here. I'm gonna go in with Urban Decay 24/7. It's my under eye, and it's in the color Perversion. But first, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in with a little bit of color under my eye. So I'm probably gonna start like, and that's the color Confidence. I'm just going in with a little bit under my eye. Sometimes it could be this under eye can be because sometimes it feel like you're getting it. Inside. I mean, you're really not. But you're just so paranoid that you do feel like you're. So, I've taken care of that, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and lucky when we get this pencil, I don't have to do a whole lot with it. Y'all see how instantly that made my eyes like boom pop. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go do my under eye with the color Fawn. I'm just about to highlight just a little bit. And y'all be seeing the people who be doing them full triangles under their face. You don't have to do all of that because it's going to travel when you blend it. It's going to travel in whatever direction you're doing it with the beauty blender. So. Yeah. And you kind of want to do it wherever the light naturally hits you. I'm going to take my beauty blender. Well, it's by Real Techniques. I'm going to blend. And what this does is it brightens it up. Brightens your face. It kind of gives you like a little facelift. Yeah, y'all see that under there. Just make sure you blend really well. My beauty blender is a little damp, in case you were wondering. Or in case you've never used one. Some people wouldn't. They don't know if they've never used one. Or you might be using it the wrong way. The first time I used one, y'all, I did not know it was supposed to be wet. I didn't. I had no clue it was supposed to be wet. But I figured it out. Done blending. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set it a little bit. I'm gonna do that with this, and it is my Mineral Veil finishing powder by Bare Minerals. Yeah, I don't know. I think this stuff costs, I'm not sure. It's from Bare Minerals. I got it in gratis when I worked at Sephora. If you don't know what gratis is, it's what everybody who works in cosmetics and makeup looks forward to. It's your free products for the month for working at that store. And I'm not gonna bake. I'm just about to set this a little bit. I'm gonna wipe it away. Because anybody got time for that? In the words of Sweet Brown, nobody got time for that. So I've done that. Now I'm about to sweep it all away. And what I'm about to do now is contour a little bit. And what I'm going to use is the True Complexion Contour Palette by Black Radiance. And this in the color medium to dark. And this is the powder one. It's not the cream one. I don't like creams too much for contouring. I'm going to go in the contour color right here, and I'm using a Kat Von D. It's a dual-ended brush, but I'm going to use the contour side, which is the angle side, and I'm going to go in with that. Y'all see that? Also want to kind of blend that in a little bit too. Okay, so I'm just blending that a little bit. You don't want no harsh lines. I saw somebody who posted on social media the other day, and they do their own makeup really well. First of all, let me say they have skills. But they posted someone that they had done, and the person's contour was not blended at all. Like, y'all, you can see the lines they drew, everything. We don't want that. And of course, those things come with practice, so I'm not downing anybody. At one point, I look like an absolute fool too. And sometimes I still do if I'm trying something new, but right now I'm just going in and contouring my nose, and this is another Wet n Wild brush that I'm using. But I don't really do anything too extreme. Simply because I kind of want to go in with a blending brush. This is a Wet n Wild blending brush. And I'm gonna go in and blend this. Blend that a little bit. And I'm gonna go back in with this. And you always wanna go, like, I got a big forehead. So sometimes I just gotta contour a little bit. And sometimes what helps is you can do a number 3. Yeah. You don't do too much. Do want to do a little something, because my head, I got a 5, 6, 7 head. That's what Samaya say anyway, mommy. You got a big head. And you want to conceal that double chin just a little bit. And I'm just going in there with this one again, the dark contour color. And just, y'all see how my double chin just went away real quick? Look at that. Back in with this brush. This is a Real Techniques blush brush, but I'm using it. Some people do the little line right there when they trying to contour their face. I don't necessarily like that. And then I'm going to do my powder. And what I use is Black Radiance. And this is in the color Bronze Glow. It's their pressed powder. And you can find this at your local drugstore too. I'm going to go in with my Real Techniques. Do I want to use that? No. I'm going to use this brush, which is a Wet n Wild one. And I'm just going to go in there. And I'm going to brush it over just a little bit. Yeah. Done with that. Now what I'm about to do, y'all, my little southern slang is coming out, but I can't talk proper. What I'm going to do next is my highlight. And for that, I think I'm gonna use Fenty and Me Money Hustler Baby. What is that? What did I do with it? What did I do with Me Money? sister, baby. Okay, here she go right here. Fenty Beauty. And you see it says Mean Money Hustler Baby. This is, I like this highlight. I do not like that other one. That real crazy gold one. Because it's too yellow for me. But this one is just perfect. I'm using a fan brush. Wet and Wild again from that set. I'm just gonna go and dust a little bit. Can y'all see that? Yeah, I saw them do the top of your lip. A little bit. Just the side. Right now. Sometimes I do the sides of my face, sometimes I don't. For this video, I will, just for y'all, so y'all can see. That's enough of that. Then I go back over it with a brush. I don't like all that harshness in my highlight. Next, I'm going to use some mascara. Let's see it. Okay, so I'm gonna use the Superhero Mascara by It Cosmetics. And I always put mascara on before I put my lashes on. I feel like it helps them go on easier. Just be careful not to blink too hard, because depending on the mascara, it might not dry in time. And it may imprint on your face. I have this happen to me often. Not only that, because I have clients that aren't used to people getting close to their eyes. And so, it imprints on their face and then it ruins their face. Well, not completely ruined. I have to fix it. Okay. All right, the lashes I'm using came from King's Beauty, and it's called Miss 3D Volume Lash, and it's in the style M371, and I'm going to use them, and I'm going to apply them with hair glue. I don't care what y'all say. I use hair glue because it dries in 30 seconds, and it's easy for me to take them off and pull the glue off the strip and reuse them. Also, eyelash glue burns my eyes really bad, and it takes forever to dry. I just don't like it. The one eyelash glue that I do like is Huda Beauty. But once you get them lashes on, baby, you're going to have a time getting them off. So if you put some lashes on with her glue, you better plan on keeping them on for a long time, because her lash glue is no joke. All right, now I'm just cleaning off my tweezers. I don't know what this stuff is on. All right, so I'm just gonna use a regular pair of tweezers. And I'm gonna take these lashes off of him. I like these, but I've never used I've used this brand before. But I've never used this particular style. And so I'm just gonna blow it a little bit so it can get just a little bit tacky. Yeah, I might have to take a break. Let my phone charge up a little bit before I do my wig. mess it up. Let that glue dry now. They're cute though. But another reason I use hair glue is because if I mess up, I can just pull it from up here, rub it, and it comes right off. So I'm gonna wait till it dries a little bit. Sometimes lashes can be tricky about the placement. You don't want them looking crazy on you. Yeah. I got the dog on. Glue all of my dog on eyelid, on my eyelid. There you go. There you go. And I had to pull the whole thing off. So let me go back in. Kat Von D liner. That fixed that. I pulled the glue off. Let's hope the second time is a charm. Nobody is perfect. Y'all have bloopers. And if I didn't tell y'all the price, these lashes are, I think, $2.99. But they're not, they're made from silk. They're not mink. Which I don't really care for silk, but I'm out of my lashes that I like. So, and I knew I was going to be doing this video, so I needed to get something. That kind of looked a little bit similar, but these are a little bit harder to work with. They're shiny, which I don't necessarily like. I'm thinking what I'm gonna do to lock this in. I'm gonna spray my face with some Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. y'all. I promise. I think I'm sleeping this and wake up in the morning and be fabulous. But it's been nice for y'all watching me. It's been good. It's been real. I'll be back with my wig tutorial in a few minutes. See you guys later.